We all know the 8 planets in the inner solar system, from Mercury to Neptune. But beyond this, there is a vast expanse called the Kuiper Belt and the scattered disk, where even more planets can be found. These trans-Neptunian planets are also a part of our solar system. In this video, we will take a look at 10 of these mysterious dwarf planets and what humanity has found out about them. Number 1. Eris. The planet Eris is almost an exact twin of Pluto. Eris has slightly more mass, but is just a little smaller than Pluto. The biggest difference is that Eris is very white. It is in fact whiter than snow on Earth. One orbit around the Sun takes Eris 550 years, while for Pluto it is 250 years. Eris is named after the Roman goddess of chaos and discord, which is quite fitting, considering that its discovery in the year 2005 led to the demotion of Pluto from being the ninth planet to a dwarf planet. Eris has a small moon named Dysnomia. Other than its size and its bright white color, we don't know what exactly Eris or its moon look like. Even the Hubble Space Telescope shows them only as small dots of light. Currently, Eris is the largest planetary body in the solar system that has not been visited by a spacecraft. Number 2. Haumea. The strangest shaped dwarf planet of all is Haumea. It is almost as large as Pluto or Eris, but has an elongated shape due to its fast spinning. A day or one spin on Haumea is only 4 hours long. Its orbit is relatively close to the inner solar system. It is just slightly beyond Pluto. Haumea is named after the Hawaiian goddess of fertility and childbirth. This planet has two moons that we know of, called Hiaka and Namaka. These were named after Haumea's daughters. Haumea was initially thought to be very white, like Eris, but later measurements revealed a more grayish color. When Haumea passed in front of a star in 2017, it was discovered that it has a ring around it, just like Saturn, but much smaller. We know that Haumea has a large red spot on its surface. Except for that, we do not know what this planet looks like, and there are many guesses. Number 3. Sedna. Sedna is currently relatively close to the Sun, closer than Eris actually. However, Sedna has an enormous orbit that takes almost 12,000 years to complete. Some astronomers speculate that Sedna is a member of the inner Oort cloud, the vast sphere around the Sun where most comets come from. It is also possible that it was captured from another star system. Sedna has one of the reddest surfaces of any object in the solar system, almost as red as Mars. The astronomers who discovered Sedna named it after the Inuit goddess of the sea, which is said to live at the bottom of the Arctic Ocean. Number 4. Pluto. Pluto is of course the best known dwarf planet. After all, it was officially the ninth planet for over 70 years. Pluto's demotion to the status of a dwarf planet is still controversial, because the smaller planets like Mercury or Earth would likely also be considered dwarf planets if they were located further out in the solar system. Pluto is named after the god of the underworld in classical Greek mythology. Pluto is currently the only trans-Neptunian dwarf planet that has been visited by a spacecraft. The images we received from the New Horizons probe show surprisingly varied geography, from dark mountainous regions like the Cthulhu Regio to the dune fields and plains such as the Sputnik Planitia. Pluto has 5 satellites: Charon, Nyx, Hydra, Kerberos, and Styx. The Pluto-Charon system is in fact the only known double planet in the solar system. This means that Charon is not actually orbiting Pluto. Instead, both Charon and Pluto are orbiting a center of gravity that is outside of Pluto. Number 5. Makemake. Makemake is the third largest dwarf planet. It is just slightly smaller than Pluto and Aries. Its surface has a brownish or reddish color. Makemake's orbit takes 300 years to complete, which means it is just a little further away than Pluto. In fact, Makemake is the second brightest object in the outer solar system, just slightly dimmer than Pluto. A day on Makemake is 22 hours long, which is similar to Earth. Makemake is named after the Easter Island god of creation. It also has one small moon, which is currently nicknamed MK2. Number 6. Ceres. Ceres is by far the closest dwarf planet to Earth. It is located in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. It is the only dwarf planet that is not a trans-Neptunian object. Ceres is much smaller than Pluto, but large enough to have a round shape. In 2015, Ceres was visited by the Dawn space probe. One of the most interesting discoveries were the bright white spots on its surface, which are thought to be salt deposits. Ceres has a lot of water ice below the surface, which means it is one of the best nearby places for future colonization. Other nearby planetary bodies like our Moon, Venus, or Mercury have very little or no water. Ceres was discovered over 200 years ago and named after the Roman goddess of harvest. Number 7. Kvawar. Kvawar is one of the closest trans-Neptunian dwarf planets. It takes 288 years to complete its orbit around the Sun, which is very close to Pluto's 250-year orbits. Kvawar is larger than Ceres, but smaller than Pluto. It has a relatively dark, reddish color, but there is still a debate whether it is actually round. It does seem to have the required mass for that. Kvawar was named after the creation god of the Native American tribe that used to live in the Los Angeles area. It has a tiny moon, which was named Wayward. Number 8. Gongong. Gongong was discovered already over a decade ago, in 2007, but it has received a name only recently. It is now the first planetary body named after a Chinese mythological figure. Considering that it is the fifth largest known dwarf planet, its naming took a surprisingly long time. Just like Makemake and Sedna, Gongong has a red color. A day on Gongong is 22 hours, which is also the same as Makemake. Images from the Hubble Space Telescope showed that Gongong has a small moon. In 2020, this moon was officially named Shanliu. Number 9. The Goblin. Discovered only recently, this potential dwarf planet was nicknamed the Goblin. This is by far the most distant known trans-Neptunian object. Its enormous orbit of over 30,000 years dwarfs even that of Sedna. This is the longest orbit of any known potential dwarf planet, and place it firmly within the inner Oort cloud. The Goblin has only a third of the size of the already quite small Sedna and Ceres, which means it may be too small to have a round shape. However, Saturn's moon Mimas, which is about the same size, shows that it is possible. Number 10. Orcus and Salacia. Both of these trans-Neptunian objects are about the same size as Ceres, and both have similar orbits to each other of about 250 to 280 years. In fact, the orbit of Orcus is even shorter than that of Pluto, which means it is one of the closest dwarf planets relative to Earth. Orcus is actually the Etruscan name for the Roman god Pluto, while Salacia is named after the wife of Neptune. It is difficult to fathom the size of the outer regions of the solar system. There may in fact be dozens or even hundreds of dwarf planets there, waiting to be discovered. The orbits of the known trans-Neptunian objects also suggest that there is a much larger undiscovered planet in the outer reaches of the solar system. Considering that the first trans-Neptunian planets, other than Pluto, were discovered less than 20 years ago, our exploration of that part of our solar system has only just begun.